perspective? I mean, are you seeing crowds? Do you sense that they're bigger, smaller, louder, quieter? I mean, what's your... Can you get a feel for what your perspective is, what attendance is like?
Compared to...
Like past years, last year?
I feel like overall ACC hype has been, you know, pretty high. You know, we got three teams in top 10. Mm-hmm. So obviously those crowds are pretty packed, and when they come in a different team, when they come in different areas, you know, they bring a great crowd, and you know the home team always brings a crowd to see, you know, how your team fares against top 10 team, and yeah, I feel like the crowds overall have gotten a lot bigger from when I was a freshman to now.
Thanks, Nathan. Thank good luck, man.
Thank you.
How does it feel to be bowl eligible, you know, for the second straight year?
It feels great. Going to a bowl game last year was a lot of fun. But like I said earlier, we're not finished. We want to, you know, keep winning games. We want to keep winning out and being the best Duke team that we can be. And obviously, you know, win a bowl game whenever we get there and see how we fare when we get there.
I'm sure you had the belief that you could win in Blacksburg. But take me to that moment, victory formation. What was it like?
It was great. It was... I looked up before the first down play I had and realized that, you know, another first down would have iced the game. And, you know, we got the first down. And when I looked back and I gave the victory formation, I was like, okay, they must have did the calculations that, you know, we can take three knees and end this game. And it was just a great feeling. After that last knee, it was just like, wow, like, you know, we kind of reached a huge goal for our program. And it was a huge program win and huge win for Coach Cut. You know, he really wanted to get over that hump. And it just really shows the caliber of our team and the fight. And to win that game on the road, it was huge for our team. And I'm looking forward to seeing how much farther our team can really go. And it's a fun ride so far.
Not only bowl eligible, but you clinch in October. Did you ever see that coming?
Yeah, I mean, that's what we, you know, all summer, you know, out here grinding with each other and working hard and sweating and just really getting our minds and getting focused that, you know, we want to win every game possible. We want to go on the road and be tough to, you know, play teams on the road and just be a tough contender in the ACC. And that's kind of how things are shaping out. And we got four tough ACC games coming up, and we're looking forward to the challenge.
I know you haven't been around for all of his 6 years, but what has the culture change been like? What does he mean by saying the culture has changed here at Duke?
It's kind of, I can't really explain, like, it's not like an outward, like, you see it much, but it's more like a focus, like a love, like a, it's really hard to explain, like, you have to be kind of a part of the program to kind of understand, like, what we feel when it comes towards, you know, Duke football, and it's kind of like, you know, we're all here for one purpose, and that's just to win games, and to earn our respect, and to do what we all came here for, and that's to change this program around, and be a part of something that's really special, and it's starting to happen, and, you know, guys are really loving it, and the confidence is building around the program and around, you know, the community, and it's a great feeling to be a part of it.
Thanks.
Thank you.
You want to talk about your young DBs in the secondary during the Virginia Tech game?
And they did a great job. I mean, there's not much you can say about it. They covered well. They played fast, and they played physical, and they didn't play scared in front of a big stage. I'm very proud of them.
All right, thank you.